टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल गिव ए लेक्चर एंड डिस्कशन ऑन द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ द सेल्स एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मैनेजमेंट एंड द टॉपिक इज ए ब्रीफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ सेलिंग एंड द सेल्स मैनेजमेंट ब्रीफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ सेलिंग and the salesman. A review of the evolution and development of the selling and sales management provides an important perspective of the marketing history. Perhaps no other area within the marketing profession has such a long history and rich tradition. Unlike many other aspects of the marketing, selling is one form or another has exerted since the early development of the civilization. This is given by the Butler in 1988. There are several aspects of the selling and sales management that are discussed in this paper. These include sales professionalism, organizational issue, and the use of technology. The literature that is reviewed is based on the three primary sources: general historical works, books and articles from the popular business space, and the academic marketing literature. In order to cover the evolution of the selling and the sales management, the paper is divided into four sections that reflect the development of this topic. The first section, Selling Through the Millennia, examines the selling activity in the ancient and classical world through the Industrial Revolution. The second section, The Emergence of Modern Sales and Sales Management, begins with the development spawned by the Industrial Revolution, leading to the modern era of selling at the dawn of the 20th century. This is followed by an overview of the rapid growth of the selling through the 1920s and the effects of the Great Depression. The continued development of the field discusses how the mobilization in World War II influenced the practice of the selling and the sales management. Lastly, conclusion and looking ahead examines the major influences on sales activity in the latter part of the 20th and the early 21st century. Personal selling is considered to be the oldest form of the marketing activity. The earliest known form of the personal selling is that of the peddler, who encompassed the selling and inventory holding function of a modern merchant. They appeared at the same time as the limited manufacture of the goods began its initial development. The peddler, also referred to as an inherent merchant, can be considered the originator of the retail merchandising. The discovery of the New World and the development of trade with the colonies expanded commerce to the new level. The later development of the steam power iron construction and the screw propeller led to the further increase in the international trade. A second type of the salesperson appeared in the early half of the 18th century, was a greeter of the drummer, employed by the suppliers and the manufacturers. Drummers were given this name because of their use of the drums to generate attention as they greeted arriving retail buyers at train station, ship docks, or hotels. Christ and Anderson, 2011. The sailing profession saw numerous development in the late 19th and early 20th century. The overall profession of the business was changing with ever larger firms creating product differentiation, brand identity, and expanded direct sales network. Large manufacturers of the branded consumer goods desired closer control over their sales force, resulting in formal sales organization that included the use of the sales manager. The professional salesperson soon replaced wholesale dummies as formally trained salespeople. Both college and the non-college courses on the sales instruction was developed to aid this effort. Education through the correspondence schools played a major role in this process. In some cases, sales education by the correspondent was such a large business that it spawned such enterprises like the Sheldon School, founded by the E.F. Sheldon. The changes that were occurring in the U.S. had parallels throughout the world. The development of the sales technique was not limited to the U.S. Research has found that there were books written in the police for the U.S. police speaking individual who wanted to learn selling methods. Not only did these books contain sophisticated business skills, but also served to the further the acculturation of the immigrant into the U.S. business environment. Efforts in other countries were also made to increase the professionalism of the selling through the training and education. England saw the development of the Sales Manager Association in 1911, as well as the publication of the Sales Promotion in the 1928. The sales literature of this period was rich in ideas and procedures, many of which are still practical today. These include supervisory practices by the sales manager, the importance of the sales knowledge of the products, and the characteristics of the successful sales people. Although the dominant character and practice of the sales profession had largely developed by this time, there were numerous events in the second half of the 20th century that would continue to evolve the science of the selling. During this time, sales and sales management activity were now considered to be more aligned with the overall strategy and goals of the organization. As with the advent of the radio advertising in the 1920s, television advertising had an even greater impact on selling in the 1950s. Advances in communication and data processing in the early 21st century have driven many new practices that include customer relationship and the supply chain management. These activities involve the selling function and expand selling reach into the other area of the business. They have created a profilation of the media channel and the customer contact points. The ability to communicate electronically via numerous new methods and technology have created and facilitated numerous changes and advancement to the selling process, with many more likely to occur. Countless salespeople now work from home office and are members of the virtual team. These individuals and processes are a great distance in time and method from the classic peddler and the drummer. However, they remain the key to matching supply with the demand between the buyer and the supplier. And the references are given. This is the brief history of the selling and the sales management. This is the brief history of the selling and the sales management. Brief history of the selling and the sales management.